In this video, we're going to show you how to use a Bunsen burner safely and how to light a Bunsen burner. First of all, let's talk about safety. You're in the chemistry lab. That means if you've got long hair, you should have that hair tied back, and you should definitely have your goggles on. If you're wearing long sleeves or something that's loose, those sleeves should either be rolled back or pulled back as well. Now let's talk about Bunsen burner safety. To start this process, you'll go and obtain a Bunsen burner and a striker from the cabinets underneath the hoods. When you get your Bunsen burner, you should check a few things first. First, check the hose on the Bunsen burner. You want to double check that the hose is in good shape and that there are no cracks along the hose. There are two valves on this Bunsen burner. The bottom valve is a needle valve that controls the gas inlet. Make sure that that gas valve is closed. The upper valve along the barrel of the Bunsen burner is an air inlet. Make sure that that valve is closed as well. Now let's look at the striker. The striker has a flint that rubs across a stone. When you use the striker, you want to make sure that you're pushing both across and down, and that there should be sparks that fly. Practice this a few times before you actually get ready to light the Bunsen burner. The last thing that you should inspect is the gas inlet valve at the benchtop. The gas valve has two positions, a closed position and an open position. It should be in the closed position to start with. And in this position, the top handle should be perpendicular to the nozzle. To open the gas valve, you would turn the handle so that the handle is parallel to the nozzle. Always make sure that it's open all the way, that it is completely parallel or in line with the nozzle. It should not be open part of the way. To turn off the gas, return the handle back to perpendicular in either direction. Now let's get ready to light the Bunsen burner. Attach the hose from the Bunsen burner to the gas inlet valve and nozzle on the benchtop. Make sure that the hose is on securely. Practice a few times with your striker again just to make sure that you're going to get good sparks. And adjust your Bunsen burner by opening the gas valve about one full turn, lefty-loosey, righty-tighty. You also want to open the air inlet valve about one full turn. Now turn on the gas at the benchtop. Again, make sure that it is open all the way. Pick up the striker and light the Bunsen burner. You've now lit the Bunsen burner, but this is a very poor Bunsen burner flame. We need to adjust this flame so that we have a good strong flame that will not blow out if people are walking by. We want the flame to be 2 to 5 inches in height, and it should not be yellow. You should see an outer blue cone and a lighter blue inner cone as well. To make this adjustment, use the air inlet valve on the barrel of the Bunsen burner. Once you have a properly adjusted flame, you should be able to hear it sputtering. This indicates that it's a strong flame with an appropriate air-gas mixture so that it won't blow out if people are walking by. If you want to make the flame larger, use the gas inlet valve at the bottom to increase the amount of gas. You may need to also adjust the air inlet valve to get that good, strong, sputtering flame. When you handle the Bunsen burner once it's lit, you can always handle it from the bottom of the Bunsen burner, either by the hose or from the ring at the bottom. Those areas will stay cool. And finally, when you are done using the Bunsen burner, turn off the Bunsen burner by turning off the gas valve at the bench. Wait for your Bunsen burner to cool, and then close both the air inlet valve and the gas valve before putting it away.